Hi, hello. Welcome to Absolute Instruments. My name is Eric and I will attempt to do a simple demonstration on how do we use the SV104 Svantek noise dosimeter. So the steps that I'll be going through is how do we turn it on, how do we do a pre-calibration, and then after that run or start the monitoring, lock the dosimeter so that it will not be tampered with. And at the end of the shift, after 8 hours or after 12 hours, unlock the keypad and stop the monitoring. Thereafter, I'll do a post-calibration and turn it off. The device has been set up to do measurement with a criteria of 85 and an exchange rate of 3 dB. So in order to do the setup, we need to use the software, Svantek supervisor software to do the setup, which we'll do in a separate video. So in this video, basically we are running through how do we operate the dosimeter once it has been set up. So first of all, to turn on the device, we would press onto this button here. There is a red symbol indicating that I have to press and hold onto the button. So the on-off symbol is over here because it's red in color. So I'll press and hold until the display shows up. Okay, the display shows up, I have turned on the device. So once the device has been turned on, I need to do a pre-calibration. So in order to do a pre-calibration, I will unscrew the windscreen and then use a SV36 Class 1 sound calibrator and insert the Class 1 calibrator into the mic. So I've inserted it, and the moment I've inserted it, there is a sensor inside the calibrator that knows that I've inserted a sound dosimeter. Now, because I have set up my sound noise dosimeter to calibrate at 114 dB, so I need to make sure that I have it set up as 114 dB from the sound calibrator. Notice that the screen has turned itself off. That is a screensaver function. So what I did earlier on was to press a button to reactivate the screen so that I can see what is going through. So on the screen right now, I can see that we are going through auto calibration, and I have a factor of 0.47 previously, and a new factor is 0.36. There's a slight drift, but this drift is to make the adjustment. As long as the drift is less than 0.5, and we're still within the specification of the instrument, so I can accept the new calibration factor by pressing onto this button over here, accept it, and the device is calibrated. So at this point, I can unplug the calibrator. Okay, the calibrator will turn off by itself, so I'll just leave it aside and replace. Put back the windscreen. So screw back the windscreen. So the instrument is ready for monitoring. So at this stage, we will attach the dosimeter onto the worker and then we will run it. Usually the location to attach the dosimeter is somewhere in the middle of the shoulder. So I would pinch off part of the shirt to clip it on and then secure it. Okay, so after I secure it, then I will start the run, otherwise I'll be meddling a bit while it is monitoring. So to demonstrate how we turn on, I'm going to remove the noise dosimeter. Okay, and come back here again. Now notice how the screen turns itself off. This is to save power. And the LED light is not flashing because we have not started any monitoring. So if I want to reactivate the display, I'll just press onto the button and then I have the display showing LAS 6364 dB, and the time right now is 3:14, and it is not recording, it's not running yet. So in order to go to step number 3 to run it, I have to use these two buttons here, the down button and the right button, which there's a symbol that has a square and a triangle symbol with a line that is joining these two buttons. It means that I have to press these two buttons in order to start the recording. So the moment I press these two buttons together, the triangle will show up on top. The device has been programmed to switch off the screen after I think 30 seconds. So you know, if I don't do anything to it, the screen will go into a screensaver mode. I can extend it in a software, but in this demonstration, we'll continue with our demonstration. So we notice that the triangle is there. It is to indicate that the device is running. And how long has it been running? It's been running for about 29, 30 seconds. The screen goes off again, right? And notice that the LED is flashing. It, you know, even though the screen is off, as long as the LED is flashing green, that means device is monitoring. Okay, but I want to lock it, right? When I attach this onto the worker, I don't want the worker to meddle with it. So in order to lock it, let's activate the screen again. Press the button to activate the screen. How do we lock it? If you take a closer look at the button over here on this side, there is a red padlock symbol. So again, red means that we have to press and hold. So I'll hold onto this button, 3, 2, and it says keypad lock, right? And the keypad is locked. So at this stage, we can leave the dosimeter with the worker and come back, you know, when the monitoring is done. If the worker is working 8 hours, we will come back after 8 hours. If it's 12 hours, we come back after 12 hours. There are functions to set the runtime, but we'll talk about that when we show the supervisor software. Now, let's say we're doing on manual and we want to unlock it. How do we unlock it? We activate the screen, and then to unlock it, the sequence is down, right, enter, and down. So it's a 1, 2, 3, 4. So let me demonstrate. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's a sequence, and once the sequence has been keyed in, the keypad would unlock. And at this stage, let's say I want to stop the recording. So again, the square button and the triangle button over here, press these two buttons together. And we see that the device has been put into a pause mode. The runtime is about 2 minutes and 11 seconds, and either I stop it right now, which is indicated over here, or I continue. So if I, you know, if for whatever reasons I need to pause the recording in the middle of the monitoring, this is what I'll do. You know, I would press these two buttons and it will go into a pause mode. But if I want to continue and press this button, that means to restart to continue with the monitoring, or if I'm done with the monitoring, I want to stop it, so I'll press this stop button. Again, you notice that the screen has turned itself off. Let me reactivate the screen and stop it. So at this stage, I've gone through on, pre-cal, run, lock the screen. We have unlocked the screen and we have stopped the monitoring. It's indicated by a square on top, and it's indicating the clock 15:18, so it's about 3:18 in the afternoon. So the last step, remember to do, is to do a post calibration. So in order to do a post calibration, I will unscrew the windscreen again, and then insert the calibrator into the mic. Okay, secure it, and I'll make sure I select 114 because my instrument is set up with 114. The screen has gone into sleep again, so let me turn it back on again. Now we can extend the sleep timer, you know, the display sleep timer if you want to, but at this stage the dosimeter is sensing the calibrator at 114 dB and it goes into auto calibration, and please wait. So the new factor is 0.28, you know, versus the previous factor of 0.36, so there's a little bit of a drift difference there, but we're talking about, you know, 0.1 of a dB. So it is, as long as the difference is less than 0.5, we have an acceptable calibration factor, so I'll accept it. So pre-cal was done, and then now I'm doing the post-cal, and at this stage here, I can remove the calibrator. Okay, I can remove the calibrator. And let's say I'm done, you know, I'm ready to turn off the device and bring the equipment back. So to turn off the device here, the red button again, press and hold onto this on-off button, and then it will shut down. And basically, remember to put back the windscreen. And basically that's it. So we have gone from on, pre-cal, run, lock, and then after that, unlock, stop the monitoring, do a post-cal, and we turn it off. Right, so in the next video, we'll show how we download the data onto the supervisor.